were back in the day, though, and you're in those mainframe rooms and you're by yourself and you're struggling. I mean, there's got to be a struggle, of course, to try and figure this all out. I mean, what was your, was it just pure excitement at the time? And you're this internal excitement that was driving you to just keep going and going till you got the puzzle solved?
Well, that's a good question. That's one of the best questions I've ever heard. What motivates somebody who's a researcher? What motivates them to go? I don't, you know, you say, well, is it the pleasure of the puzzle or is it the discomfort and not knowing? I think it's deeper than that. It's just, that's what I do. That's what I do. I do that and I play banjo and I get lost in it. Mm. That's my meditation. I have to do it. If I can't play music, something dies. And same with solving puzzles. That's who I am and that's what I do. And I don't think of it as there's something that pushes me to do it. That's just who I am and that's what I have to do.
Yeah. I still feel like I'm in training wheels, but I sometimes feel like my career is the same way. I don't necessarily know why. I'm just driven to do what I do, and I'm not necessarily sure what I even do, but I just do it.
Yeah, I like that. And you're good at it. And you're that's one of the places I think we succeed in the tribe when we get people to this place you're at, where you find out who you are and what you do, and you just do it, and you express yourself, and you create a value by expressing exactly who you are, not pretending to be somebody else. That's a very high state. Congratulations for being there. It'd be a different world if everybody could get there, and I, you know, would hope people would follow in your footsteps. And I've watched your career over many years, and I've seen you keep expanding and getting closer to who you are, and now you're really blooming and you're really making a big contribution.